Okay, well, now it's time for Purchase or Pass. And in tonight's Purchase or Pass, we take a look at a completely different type of property to what Chris normally looks at, analysing something right in the heart of Tom's auction territory. And here it is right now. It's a single level semi-detached property, which is definitely in need of some renovation. It is freestanding to the north side and has two bedrooms, kitchen, and a large bathroom and internal laundry. It's located just 6 kilometres from the centre of the CBD and is quietly located on the border of two suburbs. So you're in the heart of the local facilities. Now, the property recently sold for $800,000, and it's not $800 there, $800,000 obviously, and would get $500 a week rent now, or around $750 a week after a major renovation. What do you guys think of this one? Like, is there anything you notice in it that stands out, George?
Look, I personally like little terraces, semis like that for investment, purely for the future capital gain, particularly in an area like that that's close to the CBD. I believe capital gain is going to be one of the biggest aspects. But also, with very slight improvements, you can increase the income quite substantially from the figures that were mentioned there.
Because 550 on 800,000, is that, I mean, you wouldn't call that good rental return, or would you?
Yeah, no, I wouldn't. I think there's room for improvement in that property, definitely. And it wouldn't take too much, I would imagine, to improve on it. Just a makeover, not a major renovation even, just a makeover, getting it ready.
Anything you noticed in that one, Tom?
I agree with George. I think it's good buying, because when you look at real estate, Ingrid, you're not only looking at just rental returns, you're looking at capital gains. And I know that traditionally that Chris likes to put a lot of apartments in which show a better rental return. But I think what you find with properties that are so close to the city, you can't reproduce land, and that's where a lot of the capital growth is. So they're hot. They go up, you know, when the market goes up, they go up $100,000, $200,000 in a really short period of time. The downside is that if you're someone that hates maintenance, older homes that are 80, 90, 100 years old, they do have issues, sometimes dampness issues, sometimes they have termite issues. So you've got to get used to knowing that you're going to maintain them, and the rental return's going to be lower, but you always make it in good capital growth. And Newtown Enmore, where this property is located, it's a hot spot. People want to be there because of the universities, because of the hospitals, because of the great lifestyle that King Street's got to offer. I think it's good buying.
Absolutely, Cheryl. No, I agree. And I think Enmore particularly, because it as a result of Newtown having grown as much as it has, Enmore is taking advantage of that. And I believe there's huge capital gains still to be made in those areas. They've never really had the jumps that we've seen in the eastern suburbs. They've just consistently grown and grown over the years. So I think it's just a great opportunity for people to buy into an area.
So what happens a lot of times, and you would have seen that, George, is that the suburb next to a suburb that's taken off seems to be the one that's good buying, because you're actually going in before the huge swing upwards. And Newtown has a suburb that's had outstanding growth.
That window has got to be pretty small, though, by the time it jumps in value, the suburb next to it, right? I mean, you've only got a small window to get the good value.
It's not days, so you don't have to wake up and do it the next morning, but I think it's probably months, and that's the advantage of being an active, passive hunter, because you can pick up trends very quickly.
In terms of renovating, if you're just doing it as a rental, is it worth renovating? Is it only for capital gain, or is it worth renovating even if you're just having it as a rental?
Look, I think it's really important to at least do some basic renovating. The type of tenant you're going to attract, the income you're going to get increases, improves, more longevity in your tenants. So I think it's important to do some work. I personally wouldn't renovate fully. I wouldn't go on a high-end renovation, something that I was just going to rent out, because you've got to consider the return. Different if you're going to move into it, or if it's going to be a place, or if you're selling it and you want to just have the capital gain. But I do believe you've got to do at least something.
Okay. Well, let's move on now. It's time to take a look around Australia and see what unique properties are up for sale this week. Joining